Welcome everybody, here we are at Foxhill for the VMXdN Evo edition, first running on MXN TV. We're going to knock this little vlog together, hope you really enjoy all the action that you've seen. The event's now done and dusted, but we've caught it all on this very camera, so sit back and enjoy what has been an unbelievably epic event. All this has been brought to you by the guys at Bell Helmets making this happen, so thanks to them. Enjoy folks, I'm going for a cold one, unbelievable. Right, here we are in the hub. This is where it's all going to happen. A plethora of bikes here.
A what?
A plethora. I can't speak.
Plethora.
Thank you. You should do the presenting.
Yeah,
sorry about that. It's been a long day already. We're only midday. I'm here with Wobbs, one of the promoters. But way more than that. Let's talk about the event first, Wobbs. You sat down with King, I think it was, in what, October or something last year. And to his credit, he's already said this was your idea, this Evo gig.
Yeah, well, he came to me at the last event we used to do together, mentioning no names, them who shouldn't be mentioned, and said to me, I've been pushed out, kid, what do you think? Would you do this event if I wasn't here? And I immediately said, we should do something together.
Insight is amazing. I could talk all day, Wobbs, but you and I both got other stuff to do, haven't we?
Yeah,
so, look, thanks for your time, mate. I'll get the sweat off my palm. Well done
on everything. Thank you. Cheers,
there you go, Wobbs.
I hope everybody has a good weekend. That's all we want. I want it to feel like a 90s Grand Prix. If we do that, we've succeeded.
It's feeling like a 90s GP already. As I said, I was fortunate enough to race a few around here. I've got to say, I'm probably more nervous than I was when I used to race, Wobbs, yeah, just doing the live stream.
Me and you both.
I'm happy then.
Good.
For today.
Is there anything moving around you? Are we happy?
No, I think we're good. Everything's all good.
I think I got the best in the business.
I found a guy who is unflappable. Like the world could be ending and they'd be like, oh, we're just adjusting. That's what we need. Professionalism. Right, I think they want to talk to you if the camera's everywhere.
Yeah, if you can, right, that'd be great. Oh, well, let me turn that off. I'll do that in a minute. How are you? All good?
Good, you? Yeah.
Yeah, you probably don't remember, but from the Red Bull Pit Bike of Nations.
Okay, yeah.
I was the UK team manager.
Are you?
I still want to put a protest in about your bike.
Are you?
This year as well. Are you doing it?
Yeah.
Oh, right, this is going to get serious then. I'll tell you, this could get out of hand, this interview already. You've raced in the UK a couple of times, I think.
Yep, yep.
Donington was
Donington and Matterley, yeah.
Matterley, yeah, but never here.
Never here.
Have you ever seen it on video or anything?
I mean, occasional clips here and there. I've never sat down and watched it, so, you know, but just got done walking it, so it looks good.
Yeah.
There's some sharp shale out there, though, so. But it is
welcome to Europe.
Well, I've seen that.
Oh, you've had a bit of that. You know that.
You guys live on a rock face over
absolutely.
Here.
Absolutely. Well, you know, yeah, and you've ridden that track in Italy as well. You know,
yeah.
So you've ridden a good few.
Yep,
So being out front. But I heard you say in an interview yesterday with Max, and you're saying, you know, obviously you're not going to lose sight of you're a retired racer. So you're going to keep it. I think your term was in your box.
Exactly. So, I mean, everybody's asked how much you've been riding. Honestly, it's been 4 or 5 months since I've rode. But you know, I mean, you don't ever lose it. Fitness you lose real quick. So, but no, it's been so far. We got to ride the bikes yesterday. It's been good. Just walk the track. Everybody here, you know, Doc Wobb's place has been awesome. So, you know, it's been open arms and you know, welcoming. So it's been great.
Even you should see what he's got.
I'm saying we need to get out that gate and not get pelted by the roost. I think they put loads of water down tonight. I think they've done a good job with the track, to be fair. Bikes were all ready. We're all ready to rock and roll. I think it's going to be a good day tomorrow and Sunday.
It's better prep here than what it was back when I was racing. In the Maxis anyway, not the MX National.
He's the only person I want to beat, honestly.
if we get a wee ding dong, it's going to be like, oh, you can't be complete. What happens on the track stays on it?
Oh.
unbelievable.
What are you actually doing right now? I can't believe you.
I'm a full-time dad.
Full-time dad?
Full-time dad, yeah. No. I've just been doing my own thing, enjoying life. Summer on the beach. Now decided to do a bit of scrambling, a bit of two-stroke.
What is this? What are we on?
It's a 2001 CR250 that Gary's built. And it's unreal. I think like every nut and bolt's been touched. Spent his time, money. Glad I want mine because I'd have been bankrupt by now, but the thing is unreal. Like, we had a bit of trouble yesterday trying it, but the boys were up all night swapping motors and stuff. This is better than a Grand Prix, really. It is unreal.
I think we're in for some good racing this weekend.
Go down when Ryan goes down.
Good racing. It's going to be some good people in the class, so
we go down,
yeah,
when you go
there's
down.
Quite a few modern bikes.
Lots
though, I'm not gonna lie,
a few modern bikes,
yeah, let's just say there's question marks.
I'm not even the man I want to talk to,
we've lost count.
Look here, Tim. You're ready to go, ain't you?
I'm lost.
This is what the people want to see.
I know.
Class are you in, Dave?
I'm in over 35, young 35, Super Evo.
So, what's your prediction?
Just try not to come last.
There you go.
That's it.
Camera Paul. Most of these old boys are from your era. You've got a bit of input in it, the whole event. What do you reckon?
Hey, it's great.
It's great.
The end. Yeah, lots of people I grew up with. I'm glad I'm not riding.
You must have some tails, Paul.
No.
Foxy with no tails?
No tails. Only how crap I rode it.
You're a conversation about a politician.
That's me.
What's that? I thought this was going to be more interesting, I didn't come.
Yeah. Politician me.
There you go.
It's right. Great, what an event. See you next year.
It's a big old name, that one.
Been signing legs like that?
Not yet. He's lucky I'm not in his era though, I think. Yeah. I see him giving me the look. I think that is like, he's like,
who even are you? Who are you?
I'm coming for him.
I don't know who prepped that bike. I don't know who done that. They need Villopoto to do the jet and he knows his stuff.
What are you reckon, Paul?
No good for my stuff.
Come in, Lewis. How's your weekend been so far?
I've never spanned the T-bars as much in my life. It's been tough, yeah. My van's like a graveyard for CR250, 89s, 88s, but yeah, hopefully this one I see out the day and yeah, should be alright.
That's all that matters, you've just got to get to the end, isn't it?
Yeah, well, the first qualifying was alright, and then I didn't have any back break for the last lap. First race we done two laps, and then I did finish the second race, so that was positive.
That's a positive thing. Where did you finish?
Third in the second one. I had a little tip over in the first corner just because I thought I was on my modern bike and thought I could brake, but this thing doesn't stop, so.
What do you reckon on the event as a whole, though?
Oh, it's mint, yeah, mint. It's, there was that many people in the UK that actually like watching motocross, but yeah.
It's the old boys bringing them out.
I know, it's brilliant. I said earlier, I've not seen this many people at a race since probably Des Nations, like 06 or something, so it's mint. And it's good to see there's people actually still into motocross, so proper good. Bit of a buzz.
Well, good luck in the rest of your races. Mate.
Thanks, mate. Hopefully, see it through.
What are you saying?
You love it when I
drive. What are you doing anyway?
I'm filming, mate. I've been about. What
yeah,
are you saying?
Yeah, where have you been?
I've been, I was talking to old Tony, mate, a second ago.
How's he getting on?
He's finished one race so far.
Oh, right.
There you go, that's what I do, isn't it?
Track looks better, doesn't it?
Well, there's a bit more moisture in it.
Not as dusty, is it?
A bit tack. That's all I'm at. Look at the hair, mate.
Getting a lot of comments. I haven't rode it yet. We're in a practice, but
it
sounds like it's running a bit better, so hopefully we'll be alright.
Running like that noseball.
Yeah.
What do you reckon, better or worse than yesterday then?
Track looks better.
Yeah.
Body's worse.
Was it bad? How was it yesterday then on the bike?
Other than the dust, it wasn't so bad, you know?
What happened in the second one then?
I got a super bad start. I was late on the gate, and then I made a big mistake over here, stalled the bike.
Have you come through the pack a bit?
Yeah, I was bringing up the rear.
Better start this far. I honestly beat Brownie. Can't walk away without a win.
I know.
Brad rolled in Ryan's gate, set him out. But no, he don't have no strength.
That's good, isn't it?
Crowd's unbelievable. Fair play. Generally, wish I was racing now.
No, I'm good, mate. A little bit horsey. Obviously, just constantly talking, aren't I? But that's my job, isn't it, I suppose. Live stream, I think, is going well. What an event. Incredible. There was a small part, and I have to say small part, I thought, oh, I'd like to be out there. Then, obviously, common sense washed over me. And I thought, no, I wouldn't want to be out there. I'm quite happy here in the commentary booth. But yeah, it's been quite immense, mate. It's fair play to Wobbs and Kinger and everybody. I mean, this literally is like what the GPs used to be like. I mean, if we could get a quarter of this crowd back to British Motocross on a regular basis, it would be brilliant.
What's been the highlight then for you?
I think the highlight for me probably, I would say just then, there was a little run in that last race where Brad Anderson and Villopoto got together. Villopoto got back in front of him and give Brad a sort of casual look back, and I thought, how mad's that? Like, literally two riders like Villopoto and Anderson going at it. There's been too many highlights. It's just been one low light is some tow rag smashed up our picnic table. Yeah, but you always, it is mindless violence. What's wrong with these people? We should make these events fun. You always get idiots coming along, but other than that, brilliant.
Right, so the Ricky Johnson Bell Moto 10 was nothing more than a pleasure to do. And I was just saying to Paul that, don't take this the wrong way, I could paint those for free. And Chuck Davies' Bell Moto 10 as well, which is the David Pingree replica as well. As a moto guy, growing up in that era, absolutely love those. All about looking at the retro paint jobs, so it was a pleasure to do. And when Bell Power Sports asked her to do it, more than happy. It was a bit of a squeeze, we had to like fit it in. But for this event, like you can see, oh my God, it's amazing. The sun's out, the paint jobs are flying around there. There's been some really good other paint jobs as well, which I've seen, because I've been clocking absolutely everyone. And I'm going to be biased and I'm going to say that the two bells that we've done were awesome. And I think that it's gone down pretty well on the bell stand as well. So we love doing that. So next year, let's do it again. What a weekend. My throat is shot. I didn't even go in the beer tent either. Incredible. I did for a couple. The VMXdN here at Foxhill has just smashed it out of the ballpark. Home run every time. It's been unbelievable. It's been such a shot in the arm for British Motocross. I hope all our domestic series and everybody looks at this and works out a plan to work together. It's just shown how good it can actually be. But I'll be back for more at this event. It was emotional, having ridden in that era and ridden GPs at this track. So I'm sure Kinger and Wobbs are in a hell of an emotional state. But we'll be doing this again. I hope you've enjoyed this particular little vlog that we've been putting together. And until next year, keep on rocking in a free world. Awesome.